now your weather forecast with meteorologist Jasmine Lomax.
Welcome back. Well, we are continuing to monitor showers moving across the state. They're starting to become a little bit lighter, and the rain that we've seen has more so been on the light side. We've even seen a few areas with some drizzle, but these showers are going to continue into the evening and early night. Then after that, we are talking a mainly dry picture. So this is the current setup. There is a low pressure system over the state and a warm front as well that's led to warmer temperatures in some areas, especially along the coast. But towards the bottom of the screen, there is a cold front, and behind that, we're seeing some cooler temperatures and some drier air that's going to work its way through our area, leading to a nice and cooler day tomorrow, but also some dry conditions as well. So around midnight, most of that rain does begin to move a little bit further to the east, and we're just left with a bunch of clouds in the air. Those will stick around into the morning, but as we head into the early afternoon, we start to see a break in those clouds and a lot more sunshine appears, and it's going to stay there as we head into the afternoon and evening. We start to see clear skies. Then on Sunday, starting off with a few clouds as well, but the good news is throughout the weekend, it's staying nice and dry. Temperatures around the region really vary from the 30s to the 50s and 60s. Oklahoma City, one of the cool spots at 35. Houston at 55. Shreveport a little bit cooler at 47. We're sitting at 58, and over the past 24 hours, we're a little bit warmer. We're about 3 degrees warmer than we were this time yesterday. But just to our west, a lot of areas in blue and purple indicating a cool down over the past 24 hours, and that's going to happen for us as well. Our temperatures will start to fall and actually be a little bit below average tomorrow. Right now, we're sitting at 58, still fairly mild. Winds are out of the west northwest at around 6 miles, and around the southern portion of the state, temperatures in the 40s, the 50s, 60s, and even 70s. Fort Polk, the cool spot at 48, 55 in New Iberia, Gonzales at 65, and New Orleans actually in the 70s. This is around where we saw that warm front, so that's why we see a few areas in the 70s, including New Orleans and Houma. But overnight, temperatures are going to begin to cool down, and it'll start to feel a little bit better as well. Dew points are in the 50s and 60s for most locations, so it does feel a little bit muggy outside, but going forward, it's going to feel a little more comfortable and a little more like winter. Overnight, those showers will end, and we're looking at cloudy skies as we start the day. Temperatures falling into the 40s, very close to where they should be this time of year, but our high temperatures are going to be a little below average. We're rising into the upper 50s, almost 10 degrees below where we should be. And notice, we do start to see some more sunshine as we head into the afternoon hours. Then overnight, mostly clear skies, and the weekend looks to be great as well. So if you haven't strung your Christmas lights yet, it's going to be a great day to do that on Saturday and on Sunday. We're also talking nice weather for picking Christmas trees, and by kickoff for the LSU game, we're talking low 50s. So it's going to start to cool down as we head into the evening hours. Now, we've partnered with iHeartRadio Baton Rouge to give you your weather on the go, and this is what we're looking at over the next few days. The main thing is that it's really going to be a mostly dry picture over the coming days, and a quiet pattern as well. 58 tomorrow, 61 on Saturday, 62 on Sunday. Then as we continue to go forward, we're talking lots of sunshine, 60 on Monday, 57 on Tuesday. Notice those overnight lows a little bit cooler in the 30s, but we start to warm up as we make it into the end of the week. We'll be right back.